Hello all. So in last video, we saw how can we fetch row index and column index from our data frame. Now let me go back to the data set which I have. So this is the very first data set which we saw, and we plotted a bar chart on top of that. So what this data tells me is like most of the hosts are either having entire home or private room. Or we can also say that people who visit New York City, most of them stay in entire room or the private room. Okay, now this second data set which I have, so this is again by a room type, but let's assume like we ignore the room type because we already seen the data by room type. So what other data point we have here is neighborhood group. So now if you look at the grand total, so what this grand total tells me is like most of the hosts are in these two neighborhood groups. Alright, or we can also say that most of the people who visit New York City stays either in Manhattan or in Brooklyn group or in Brooklyn neighborhood group. Okay, so even if we ignore this room type, okay, and we considered only this last row, which is a grand total, this tell me that by, I mean, we can plot the data, our data, or we can visualize our data by only by neighborhood group. Okay, so to plot a pie chart on top of this data set, what we'll do, we'll ignore rows. I mean, we'll ignore the room type because that data we have already seen. And we consider only the grand total. Okay, so grand total and columns. So column wise grand total. All right, and on top of this data, we'll plot a pie chart. What I mean is, let's go back to our original data set. So this is my data frame. Okay, now since I am interested only in last row, which is nothing but total percent, what I will do, dot LOC, I need only last row, so that is total PER, and I need all the columns. Okay, I got this data set. And so it's returning me, it's a series. Okay, so it's a series, but I don't need a series. I want to convert that into a list or the array. So what I will do for that, I will put that, since series is an iterable, it will return me, I can use that in a for loop, and let's print this. Oops, something went wrong. Let me print this guy again. Okay, so for row in series, print. Okay, that's fine. And we also need to get rid of this percent. I will tell you why. We'll not do that right now. What I will do, I will create another list, empty list. So that would be my data values. And I will append these row values into that. And let me print this guy afterwards. Let me run this. All right, we are all set. Now we need to plot a pie chart using this data. Okay, how do I do that? So remember, if in the last videos we saw this pie plot interface, and as bar is a class, pie is also another class in that, and it accepts these different values. So the very first value it accepts is array like, so basically the data. So it accepts the data in an array which we already have. So I will simply call this constructor, so plt.py, and I will call this constructor, so x equal to my array. It failed. Why it failed? Let's check the error. What it says is could not convert string to float. Since we have this percent sign in our data, it failed. It could not convert that into a float. So I need to get rid of that. How do I do that? Replace, and I will replace percent with blank. Okay, let's check the array list. We are good here. Great. So we got a pie chart, simple pie chart. Now what missing here is, I really don't know what each color means. So I need to add a label. So let's go back to the documentation and let's see what all options we have here. So there is another option called labels and it accepts the list, okay, or an array. Now what this label is, what this indicates, this indicates the row. So if I go back here, this individual percentage indicates each and every column index, all right? And we already have column index in a list, okay? We'll use the same thing. And what I will do, I will and let me go back here. It's a labels, labels, and I will use this. Great, okay. Let's see what other options we have here. Colors, we'll come back to this color. Auto percents, or before that, let me increase the size. So if I use, so by default radius value gets set to 1. If I change that to, let's say I want radius as 2. Okay, it became a little bigger. All right. Now what I will do, I will use, let's say I want also want to see the contribution of each and every pie in that pie chart or slice in that pie chart. What I will do, I will use not this guy, auto percent. Okay, by default it's got set to none and I need to use this format string, okay, in order to get that. So we'll see that. What I will use, this percent equal to percent 2.f, so basically two decimal places. All right, we got that. If I use percent, oops, I need to add one more percent. All right, so we got that as well. It has to be 0.2. Yeah, that's better. Okay, so we got this. We also saw like how can we add actual data label. Okay, let's see what other options we have. I will make this little smaller. I will change that to 2.1.5. Yeah, this is better. Okay, now they have something called shadow as well. By default boolean, it's a boolean value and by default it is false. I will make that to true. Let's see what it changes. Shadow equal to, all right, now let's look at the last thing which we'll look at is the color. So it also accepts array like structure. Okay, what I will do, I will create another array for color. Let me add another row here, colors equal to, or maybe I will change that to color, red, blue, yellow, black, and let's say white. Okay, and I will use this guy as an argument, colors equal to color. All right, so my default colors got changed. Okay, so this is how we can plot a pie chart using Matplotlib. It is so simple. Okay, now in the next video, so we completed two exercises, like two things for our data analysis. In the next video, we'll try to formulate this pivot table using data frame. So thank you for watching this video and see you in the next video.